Hello, Year 10th, and welcome to another lesson of home learning. We're going to leave the ideas stage behind us for a little while. The reason for that is because we've done quite a lot of ideas, and I want us to take a break from that and do something a little bit different. So, what we're going to be talking about over the next couple of lessons is part of the development stage. So, we're jumping ahead a little bit, starting to actually think about how you'll manufacture your product. Okay, so we've got a few ideas. We should be up to about 12 so far. So we're now going to start to think about how you're going to manufacture your product, perhaps the materials that you're going to manufacture it out of, the tools you will use, the machines you will use, and also thinking about ergonomics, health and safety, and those types of things. So we've got a number of lessons coming up now where I would like you to think about how your product is manufactured. We're going to start today by talking about the tools and the machines. Okay, now this one, you can either do them all together as per the example on the DT website, or you can separate them into hand tools and machines separately. Okay, now this is going to test your sort of practical knowledge and also helpful for the theory exam, thinking about what tools you would use, what equipment, what processes that you would actually use to actually manufacture your product. So what I would like you to do is I'd like you, first of all, in your mind, to take your idea or take one of your ideas and think about how you'd make it. I'd like you to think about what hand tools you would use. And then I would like you on Google to go get some pictures of those hand tools, and I would like you to put them on a page. And you're going to call this one Hand Tools and Machines, this page. And then I'd like you to find some information about it. And you can find this off Google. There are lots of different websites that you can use to actually find the information. Now, most importantly, what we need to do is we don't just need to copy and paste information in. We need to think about why we're using that particular tool. So, for example, if you're planning to use a pillar drill, why is that the machine that you think would be most appropriate? If you're going to planning to use a laser cutter, as in this sample here, for manufacturing a part or a piece of your product, why is that the most important? Okay, the examiner doesn't want to see a load of copied and pasted information telling them what a pillar drill is, really. You can have a little bit of that, but really what they want to see is your understanding of those tools and machines and equipment. Okay, so you've got to talk about why that particular piece of equipment or that particular hand tool would be most appropriate for the job you're going to use it for. Okay, so it's going to take some research for you to do. You're going to need to do some research into these tools to find out why they are the most appropriate, and also the machines as well. So on this example, you can see hand tools. She started to use a she's going to use a craft knife, a hand file. She was making hers out of leather, so she's talking about a leather piercing tool. So she's done a bit of research into the materials that she's chosen. She talked about a screwdriver, a tenon saw, CNC machine, sanders and things like that. So she's starting to think about all the tools and equipment. She's got a little bit of information on there, but the most important thing, and I can't stress this enough, is you need to talk about why you've chosen that tool or that machine as most appropriate. So we're looking for two pages. You can split this up if you want to, or you can do it as a combination of the two things. We need one page on hand tools and one page on machines. Okay, so this is going to take you probably two lessons to do. We're going to start it today, one page, and then we'll do another page, a second one. Please try and cut down or try and minimize the amount of just copied and pasted information you found. Try and write it out in your own words, okay? So that you show the examiner that you really understand the tools and machinery that you're going to use for manufacturing your product, okay? So we're starting to think ahead in terms of how your product will be manufactured. If you want some hints and how and where I found this, you should know by now. It's on the IGCSE coursework page, and we're looking at page sort of 37 and 38 on there. Okay, so two pages to do over these next two lessons over this week. One page of hand tools and one page of machines, please.